Well, a very good afternoon and a warm welcome to you all as you've gathered here today to commemorate and celebrate the life of a wonderful and unique man. A wonderful man who left this world on the 14th of March at the age of 69, far too soon. A man who has touched so many lives and evidenced by so many people being here today. I was told to expect about 70. I think we've at least doubled that. As I say, I'd like to welcome you here today, and I'd also like to extend a very warm welcome to those who are joining us via live stream today. And Kyle tells me we have people tuning in from the Philippines, from Denmark, as well as also all over Australia. So a lot of other people that can't be here today to celebrate his life, but are doing it wherever they are in the world, and no doubt celebrating his life and sending him off with a smile and a cheer. And today we'll celebrate Ken's life by sharing some of the stories that you made with him along the way. We'll share some of the memories that he's left behind with you. And I'm going to open up the microphone to anybody here who'd like to say something about him and share some of your stories and tributes. You might have prepared something for today, or you might just have something pop into your head as you're sitting here this afternoon. But please do come up and share with us if you'd like to when the time comes. As much as today is about celebrating Ken's life, we must also acknowledge the sadness that comes with the fact that he's now left this world. And grief comes to us each in many different ways, but now is the time to come together as family and friends to support each other through this difficult journey by recalling those wonderful memories that Kenny's left with you will help to heal the wounds that his passing leave. And Kenny's sudden passing reminds us all that life can sometimes be cut short too quickly. It reminds us to take a moment to consider the importance of making the most of each day, appreciating the gifts that we've been given in life, just as Kenny did, and remembering that we should never miss a moment to cherish those who we share our lives with. And over his 69 years on this earth, Ken came into contact with so many people, and he's left his mark on a lot of souls. And those lucky enough to have known him will remember him as one of nature's true gentlemen. He was from the old school and he lived by those values all throughout his life. He was a firm but fair man, and he hated it when people called him mate, especially if they knew his name. But he always treated people with honesty and respect, and he was just someone that people loved to be around. And he had a great sense of humour and was always ready with a joke or something funny to share. Kenny was a hard and dedicated worker, and he was someone that you could always rely on to be there when you needed him, to lend a helping hand. And he always put the needs of others before his own, particularly his family. He had a few passions in life, which mainly revolved around sport. In his younger years, he enjoyed playing cricket and soccer, and he had quite a bit of talent for those. And he also loved to spend time at the footy. He was always down on the sidelines when the Comets were playing, supporting his son, Matt, as he was playing and cheering on from the sideline. And if you hadn't guessed it by now, he was a mad dragon supporter, hence the coffin we've chosen for today. And the flag that's on top of his coffin is that of the Philippines. It was somewhere that was very close to Kenny's heart, and he travelled over there as often as he could and spent so many happy times over there with all the beautiful people that he loved. But if he wasn't travelling over to the Philippines, you'd be pretty sure that he was going down to Woolworths instead. He'd make his way down there several times a week, just picking up a few things at a time, one of his little idiosyncrasies. But of all the things that Kenny loved in life, nothing was before his family. He loved each and every member of his family and all of his friends, and he was so proud of particularly his children and his grandchildren. And he's played a huge part in not only their lives, but also the lives of everyone here today and all those who can't be with us. And I'm sure that we can all say that our lives have been enriched for having known him. It's important to remember that his influence and presence doesn't end with his passing. The little idiosyncrasies and traits that made him the man he was, the things that he did to make you laugh, to sometimes cry, but most of all to make you love him, will remain in your hearts and memories and so live on through the days ahead. And a part of Kenny will stay alive in each of you so long as you continue to speak his name through the days and months. His legacy that he leaves behind is all of the wonderful moments that he shared with you, all of the stories that he made, all of the laughter, all of the smiles, all of the love that he gave. It was the kindness and support and friendship that he showed to those that he shared his life with. It's the way he brought up his children and his grandchildren, all those morals and that wisdom that he passed on, and each happy memory that he's left behind. We can say that over his 69 years on this earth, although perhaps all too short, he certainly enjoyed all of the good things that life had to offer. He lived a rich and fulfilling life. He's left his mark on the world, and he's now enjoying the peace that comes at the end of a life well lived. And I'd like to share now with you a little bit more about Kenny's life through the eulogy, which his children have put together for today, and it's my privilege to read it for them on their behalf now. Our father and friend, Kenny, the Big Cheese. Thank you all for being here today to help celebrate the life of a true gentleman. We're all so blessed to have been a part of Kenny's life in one form or another. It may have been growing up with him as a mate, growing up as a sibling, perhaps sharing time with him as a partner, or being brought up by him as a child. You may have met him through the years at footy, or maybe having served him at Woolworths, or on one of his many trips overseas. Just looking around today, it's easy to see that he found his way into so many people's hearts. To be able to sum up Kenny's life in just a few minutes would be simply impossible. One of the main things that Kenny was passionate about was Sundays, because Sundays meant footy, when he could watch his son, Matt, play along with all his teammates in all clubs. He enjoyed the pies and wondering if Streety was going to be cooking the chicken rissoles at the footy or not. And he was also lucky enough to see his grandsons kick off their footy careers with the Comets. In his retirement, Kenny's passion for travel was amplified, going to his second home, the Philippines, at least twice a year. His son Grant joined him on a handful of those adventures and saw just how happy Kenny was when he was over there. He received so much love and respect. Kenny's house was always open to anyone who needed it, even if they were an Arara player who needed a place to live, Arden. Kenny had developed a few addictions in the last few months, namely Bulla ice cream and rainbow bursties. None could compare, though, to his favourite, Wicked Wings, even if they were cold at the footy. The love he had for all of his family was evenly spread, and that includes Rocky the dog. And I wish I could share every memory, but there's never enough time to say. He was happy with his run at life, even though his time was unfortunately cut far too short. Salamat kaya, Ken. Thank you, elder brother. Take it easy, Cheesy. Well, thank you for putting those beautiful words together. And Grant, did you want to come up and say a few words? No. Okay, that's okay. Not easy to get up and speak on a day like today, but I'd like to open it up now to anyone here who would like to come up and share something, and just a story or a memory or a little tribute to Ken. We'll have some time now to do that.
Hey everyone. Kenny was one of those what you see is what you get kind of guys, you know. He didn't pull any punches, and he loved his life. He didn't need for much, he never wanted for much, and when his family and friends were happy, he was happy. Went and said goodbye to him this morning, and something hit me when I saw him. He's dressed in his Sunday clothes, his jean shorts and his Comets shirt. And I thought, I hope there's no dress code to get into heaven. I could just see Ken walking up and them going, eh, and Ken going, eh, where's the next plane to the Philippines? But wherever you are, mate, hope you're happy and see you soon.
Is there anyone else here who'd like to share something before we move on? We're going to take a moment now to see some photos that have been put together today. Are you coming up to speak?
Hello. Hello, everybody. Thank you for being here
to celebrate the legacy and memory of my dad, Ken Cheeseman. I feel lucky to have been able to say and explain to him how much he meant to me in our life. This is a summary of a few messages I'd sent to Dad over the time, just to let him know how much he meant to me. Hey, I just wanted to, explain something to you. That day in Dorigo way back about 25 years ago, when you were dropping me off to my biological father, Bobby, I remember you showing me how to shake hands properly out front of the Dorigo pub so I would know how to be able to greet Bobby properly. But after all those years, all I remember and appreciate from that day wasn't meeting my biological father, it was shaking the hand of the father who raised me. I'll always be thankful for how you raised me and love you for the rock that you are and always have been in my life. Here's another message. Just wanted to send you a massive thank you for everything you have done for me. I know I was a handful of a kid. That was a different word, but I shouldn't say that in church. But you have always stuck by me more than anyone in my life. I hope you know how much I have always loved and appreciate you being my dad. I still remember you taking me to the trains to work when I was really young, about 35 years ago now, as if it was yesterday. You have been my father for as long as I can remember, and you have taught me everything about being a man, a father, and so much more. And honestly, who knows how I would have turned out if it wasn't for you. I can't thank you enough for being a part of mine and my kids' lives. We all love you, Papa Cheese, forever your son, Dean.
If there's nobody else to speak, as I said, we'll take a moment to watch the slideshow that's been put together for today's service. There's some pictures that have captured the special moment of Kenny's life, and just encourage you to take the next few minutes to sit here and reflect on those beautiful memories that he's left behind with you.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more. And I never knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
So the fact that family was the most important thing to him, he followed secondly by footy and a beer. Take a moment now to share with you the Lord's Prayer, and if you'd like to say it with me, you're welcome to as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And Hayley, would you like to come up now and share a poem with us?
Hey, Dad. So, we knew our time with you was getting shorter by the days. We never expected it to be so soon. Each day you strive to live, your body too weak to be. Your love will live forever. Now your heart has set you free. We were so lucky to have that last night by your side. Now you walk so bravely. You feel the pain no more. On the sands of time, you've left your footprints with glory. Everyone shall know your name, shall recall your story. Of a kind and loving man who had a heart of gold. Those special memories of you, Dad, will always bring a smile. If only we could have you back for just a little while. Sad are the hearts that love you, silent are the tears that fall. Living without you is going to be the hardest part of all. The fact that you're no longer here will always bring us pain, but with love in our hearts, you will walk with us forever until we meet again. Salamat, mahal kita, Dad.
Thanks, Hayley. This brings us to the end of our service here in the chapel, and in a moment we're going to take Kenny from the chapel here and out to the hearse and then make our way down the road and then to the cemetery. If you'd like to join us at the graveside, you're welcome to. Please feel free to walk behind the hearse as we make our way down to the grave. And after the service, I'd like to invite you back to the Coffs Harbour Leagues Club to share some more stories and memories of Kenny and celebrate his life a bit more. So in a moment we're going to take him from the chapel and listen to one last song, and if I could ask you to please be upstanding as we do that now.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of a storm, there's a golden sky and the sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, for your dreams beat us and blow.
Last two. Okay. All right. So just. Can't this way, folks. Yeah, come out to this side. Okay, now the chap in the middle, if I can get you to hop out. Matt, can I get you to come round and lift the coffin from the end here? Okay. Put this on. Place the coffin on the straps. That's it. So Phil, can I just get you to lift the flowers, mate? And just open. Okay, please. Well, we now come to the part of the service where we say our final farewell to Kenny's earthly body and entrust him to the next part of his journey. In so doing, we're grateful for all the love and support, the guidance, the care and compassion that he showed through life. We're grateful for the many happy memories that he's made with you along the way, all those beautiful stories that he shared with you, and all the love that he gave. Ken, we release you now to the next part of your journey as we commit your body to be buried in the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. We thank you for the beautiful memories that you have left with us. We wish you sweet sleep and eternal happiness. Until we meet again, may you rest in peace, Kenny. If you've still got your order of service booklets, I'm going to share with you the poem that's on the inside now, if you'd like to turn to, and you can follow through with me. And perhaps we can all say it together. Nothing is ever lost. Imagine a cloud in the sky. Eventually the cloud will turn to rain. And the rain falls to the ground and becomes a river, which eventually runs into the sea. The cloud may not be visible, but it certainly has not been lost. That's just like the loved one we're grieving here. They aren't really truly lost. And as you leave here today, may I encourage you to continue to speak Kenny's name, to recall all of those beautiful memories that he made with you, in so doing, keeping his spirit alive for the years to come. Because someone who we keep talking about, who we keep sharing their name, will live on forever. We're going to conclude now with some rose petals here. You can come and place some on Kenny's coffin to say your own goodbye. And as I mentioned before, I'd like to invite you all back to the Leagues Club to share some more stories of Kenny and those beautiful memories, and to celebrate his life with his family this afternoon. So please do come forward and take a rose petal and place it on Kenny's coffin.
Up the mighty saints. Any rain, you won't get wet and melt.
seen too many witches here.
How about three cheers for Kenny? Hip hip?
Hooray!
Hip hip?
Hooray!
Hip hip?
Hooray!
I bet he's having a laugh now.